Right up there on that stretcher. Hard to say which leg it is.
Langlois shoots it off the boards. Bob Bond lets it drive. Goes scores! Bob Bond!
Gets it into the
mirror
back to
the
foot.
The Montreal Canadiens have won the Stanley Cup.
We begin with Nystrom. Tonelli to Nystrom. He scores!
The Oilers have won the Stanley Cup.
Time once again to go back into the archives. Welcome to Vintage Games here on the NHL Network. I'm Dan Pollard. Today we take you to May 10th, 1979. It's Game 7 of the semifinal matchup between the Boston Bruins and the three-time defending champion Montreal Canadiens. Among the most memorable games the Canadiens ever played at the Forum, it would become famous for Don Cherry's theatrics and a too many men on the ice penalty at a very inopportune time.
We have the referee Bob Myers, Ron Finn, and D'Amico, the linesman. D'Amico was an official here 14 years ago the last time, a seven-game series. There's a man who has been quite a star, an average of 2.70. Gilbert took over in the third game. He has flashed some tremendous periods of hockey. And there you have the articulate graduate of Cornell and McGill University, Dryden of Montreal, 2.46. So I have Rattel at center. Smotts and Mark caught on for Boston and the Bruins clearing it in. Here is Savard. Ahead on the right side, LaFleur into the center ice area. He lost it. Wheeling back. Smotts over the line. He fired it. And Dryden blocked that. Gainey a long right wing pass. Broken up at the line by Park. He failed to clear it out. And his stick tied up by Park. Here's LaFleur centering it. And Smotts knocked it into the center ice area. Gainey tipping it ahead for LaFleur. LaFleur along the left wing, jammed out of the play by Sims. Gainey knocked his man down. There's a shot by an unexpected starter in this game, Risebrough. Up there, he suffered a broken nose in the game on Saturday night. The puck is back in the Canadian zone. It's LaFleur taking his time. Now it goes to Gainey into the center ice area. He lobbed it ahead, and the Bruins starting back. Cashman took Milbury's pass. Cashman shooting it, and a leg save there by Dryden. Here come the Canadians, led by Trombley, down to the Boston line. Trombley putting on the breaking center, the Canadians front, and Gilbert is there. So the faceoff in the Bruins zone. It is Milbury. He had an outstanding game for the Bruins as they fashioned that decisive victory in Boston in the sixth game. Now the Bruins starting out. Milbury fired it off the boards. Dropping it up and putting it on that right side is Engblom. But he failed to penetrate. There's a shot for a sharp angle by Mondeau. Out it goes to the line. Robinson trying to keep it in. He gloved it in there. And it's tipped gently into the center ice area. Engblom is coming back against Rattel. Into the corner they go. Here's Lemaire around the net. He lost it. There's Mondeau. Mondeau getting set. He tried to center it. Rattel up in the wing. It goes to Smotts at center. Smotts putting on the brakes. Now he's forced back. Hands it off to Rattel. Rattel is in over the line. He is a smoothie. There's the pass at the line. Canadians clearing it out. Here is Milbury getting set, trying to get in there. And he was blocked solidly by Engblom. Canadians coming back. Lemaire over the line. And he lost it, wheeling back rather slowly now is Rattel. His shot did not give Dryden any difficulty. LaFleur, a splendid move by LaFleur into the center ice area. Drills the shot, the rebound. And Gilbert tucked it off on the wing. No score in this hockey game. Bruins taking over. They are playing five aside. With exactly 30 seconds left in the penalties. Now it's flipped in on the right side by LaPointe, digging in there doggedly, is shut behind the net. Up on the left side it comes. Now it's at the line, and LaFleur is forced out. On the left side, Savard couldn't get it. There's Park. He is their main man on that offensive rush. There's a forward pass, Middleton going in. Good defensive play by Savard. LaPointe, an outstanding rushing defenseman into the center ice area. Here's Trombley cutting in. He fired it. And a brilliant leg save by Gilbert. Oh, that was a great indication of that excellent reflex action that the goalies must have, and most of them do have. That was a low drive by Trombley. Now here's McNabb into the center ice area. McNabb is over the line. The shot is wide. Back it comes. Rick Smith taking a shot, a weak shot. Robinson leading a four-man attack. Rajan Uhl back in the lineup for the Canadiens behind the net. Uhl getting set, trying to center it. Middlebury getting him up. Robinson keeping it in. There's the shot by Napier. Right on. Now Rajan Uhl is getting set, trying to center it. It comes right in front of it. A wild pileup. And the Bruins come up with it. Up on the left side. Jonathan couldn't pick it up the first time. Now Napier is down with Risebrough over the line. There's the shot. And the Bruins break it up again. This is a very fast pace in the early stages. Here's Jonathan going in. And it's blocked by Dryden. In behind the net it goes. Robinson clearing it on the left side. Robinson knocked it down. Gets it out on the right side. Napier trying to come up with it. Engblom clearing it ahead. He hit Napier. Now Risebrough to the Boston line. Out there going in. Trombley, a weak dribbler. Out in front it comes. The Bruins starting out. A penalty coming up. I think it will be Lombert. And we have 10:57 left in the opening period. There's no score.
Well, Scotty Bowman's been there before, and he looks awful relaxed. As we see Rattell with that great quickness going around Robinson. Robinson gets that one arm, a little hold and just a tug. Not long enough to get a penalty call, but strong enough to stop the effect of a charge. And Dryden comes out to sweep the puck away.
Here's that play made by Steve Shutt in the center ice zone on McNabb, and he hooked the puck away from behind.
The shots on goal are now even at five. Here's Sims over on the right side. Off Rattell's stick. Ashman is following in on that right side. Now Chartrand. He collided with Jonathan Gainey coming down on that right side. He bowls over the defenseman Sims, but couldn't follow through. On the right side. Ashman over on the wing. It goes to Jonathan. Jonathan is belted at center by Chartrand. A penalty coming up against the Montreal Canadiens.
Chartrand heads to the penalty box. With the score, the Bruins nothing, the Canadiens nothing. This is Stanley Cup 79.
What about that one?
So it's bumptious out there, becoming turbulent. So Lou and Dick, fasten your seatbelts. Let's see what's going to happen here. Bruins everybody up, and the Canadiens get the draw. Lombert idles into the center ice area. Redmond getting it back to center. Here's Rattell with Middleton over the other side for Cashman. Cashman hands it off to Redmond. He shoots it, and it's off the leg of LaPointe. Redmond's got the Middleton. He scores! And the Bruins lead 1-0.
Kenny Dryden's upset about something, but the goal goes in the net and a power play for the Bruins. Lou, you talked about the Boston team having to stay away from penalties. Here we are in the early going, and they cash in on a power play.
That's right. Boston takes advantage of that power play, and we see once they get the puck in the zone, there's two people all alone in front of Dryden. And as the puck is trying to get out, one of the Bruins steals it. I think it's Rattell. He centers it right to Middleton, all alone in front. Middleton had Dryden moving across, spun around, and put it in. You'll see Rattell on the left board and Middleton all alone in front. And Middleton just putting it in as Cashman was also there in case he missed the net. He could even tip it in.
So Rick Middleton continues his five play. Cashman and Richmond assisting at 10:09. The point had eliminated himself from the play when he sprawled to block the initial shot. Boston leads it 1-0.
Now the Bruins in possession. They clear it. O'Reilly head into the center ice area. It's propelled to the corner. That's Big McNabb going after Engblom. To the other side, Napier. Here's Robinson. The Bruins up there very tenacious in their forechecking. Now on the left side, Rajan Uhl He's cutting. Pull into the corner. It goes to Lafleur. Here's Lafleur taking a look. There's the shot. And it went off Ray Jean-Hul's stick, I think. McNabb into center. Gives it to O'Reilly. Back to McNabb. He shoots it. Dryden, the big rebound. And Engblom gets it ahead. Rick Smith tipping it back on the wing. Lafleur fighting for possession along with McNabb. And then Rick Smith hit Lafleur. And the Bruins get it back into Montreal territory. 8 minutes and 50 seconds left in this, the opening period. 1-0 for the Bruins on a power play goal by Middleton. Now the teams are changing while the play goes on. At the line, O'Reilly back to Park on the right side to O'Reilly. Long left wing pass. Canadians clearing it to the boards. Now working out from the corner. Here's Tremblay. He missed Lafleur. Down the ice it goes. On the air, back after it. Here's Spots. Savard knocking it down is picked up by Marcotte. He had Miller open on that right side, but the pass was too quick and too far ahead of the Canadians, clearing it down on the left side. Mark is back after it. Over on the other side, that's Sims. The Bruins are out shooting the Canadians 7-6. They are outscoring them 1-0. There's a block pass. Tremblay coming in on that right side. Tremblay around the net. Lombard is at the lip of the creek. There it is, right in front! And Risebrough missed the pass at the open side. Right in front it comes again. Tremblay has shot. Gilbert's down. Now the puck is still loose. Here's Tremblay taking a look. There's the shot. Tremblay trying to get it in front. Lombard has it. Right in front it comes. And Lapointe fired it wide. Another shot by Lapointe. It's around the net. Great pressure here by the Canadians. In on the boards. They jostle. Will they get a whistle? Let's see. Not yet. And the Bruins come up with it. Out over the line. There's the lead pass. Here's Jonathan getting a break, going in a goal. Jonathan shoots. Oh! Tremendous save by Savard. What a play that was by Savard. Lambert shooting it back into Boston territory. And the crowd buzzing over that play. Let's see. We're having a penalty here. Miller of the Boston Bruins for hooking. So the Canadians with Lemaire, Schutt, Napier, Robinson, and Lafleur on the power play. There's Rick Smith into the corner. Napier blocks it, trying to get it. Lemaire goes after his man. Milbury clearing it down the ice. For the Boston Bruins, the ant defending. Their foursome out front. Marcotte, Redmond, Smith, and Milbury. Now the Canadians. They lose it. Redmond bringing it back in, and he almost set up Marcotte. Montreal Canadiens experiencing difficulty trying to get this power play going. Here is shut down on that right side. He's spun around. Shut goes to the corner. Where is he going to pass the back to Lafleur over on this side of Robinson into shut? Knocked off his stick by Milbury. Now we have a minute and 10 seconds left in the penalty as Robinson blocked at the line by Milbury. Napier carries on the right side. A good chip by Napier. Napier going in. He fired it. It was wide. Lemaire couldn't get a stick on it. Lafleur takes the shot. The rebound right in front. Wild scramble. And lunging out there to get it is Gilbert. It's still 1-0. Now it's Savard turning. Savard giving it to Robinson to Lafleur. Lafleur to the side, right in front. It comes to the side again. They poke away out of the backhand shot. Another shot. They score! Lemaire!
There's an oddity. Lemaire in front of the net with Lapointe and Savard. Defensemen all over on the power play, but their big size helps him to control the puck. You see Lemaire come out from behind the net, and he's going to be in position to get the last rebound off Lapointe's shot right there, put it on the ice, and sneak it through Gilbert to tie this game.
You know, the Canadians still didn't have all that much room. You just talked about that, but somehow Lemaire found the range.
It seems to be their defensemen, the big size in front, fighting for that puck to get a three.
Scotty Bowman had three defensemen on the ice right there. Robinson, and he had Savard and Lapointe. At least in that sequence, they were up front. And there you see the scoring play. So there was one time something like that paid off. 18 and 5, the two defensemen playing in tight to the net. And it's Lemaire to the left of your screen who tucks the puck home underneath Rick Smith. It's 1-1.
14:19
the time of the tying goal. Now Risebrough lobs one into the corner. Risebrough going in there along with Brad Park. Robert trying to get it. Park gets it up on the right side, and here's O'Reilly putting it on to McNabb. Stick into the corner, it goes. Dryden doing a little wandering. Now O'Reilly getting it back to Brad Park. O'Reilly again, he centered it. Dryden got his stick on it, and Savard lugs it, gets it out to the line. The Bruins are on it again. A drop pass goes to McNabb. Throws again, he waited too long. Here's McNabb again, and he dribbled his shot. The post comes off. It's Morey on the right side, so the play will be stopped. 4 minutes and 53 seconds left in the opening period. Score tied at a goal. The Bruins failed to get the draw. Engblom whipped it around the boards. It comes down the ice. Ganey is going after it. Now it's Jarvis. Jarvis over the line. His shot is away weak. Here's Rajan Uhl. Uhl trying to center it. He does. The Bruins have difficulty clearing it. And now it's Schmatz on the right side. Ross goes to center, dumped it into the corner. There's Jonathan going in after Engblom. Rajan Uhl playing it ahead. Ganey couldn't get it. The Bruins on the move again. Foster is given a shove by Ganey. Here's Uhl on the left side. There's a pass going to Jarvis. Rick Smith took it to the corner. He and Uhl, and now Jarvis, they fight for it. In on the boards it goes. And Schmatz. Rolled at the center. Over the line, Milbury back to Foster. Into Milbury, a backhand shot on the short side. That was a good give and go play.
20 shots on goal.
And right now, it's still all even. Three games each and a goal apiece in this first period as we move into the final 3.5 minutes. It is the point around the net. There's Rattel, evergreen Mr. Rattel. Shot takes it. He's in on that left side. Fakes the shot. Shot is coming. He centered it. It goes off the Fleur. And there's going to be a penalty here against Boston. Dryden is out of the net. The Fleur was upended. It was a holding infraction, I think.
Well, Donnie Marcotte doing his job, staying with Lafleur, but Lafleur's got that great speed and super acceleration, and he just gets away enough from Marcotte to be in position to score the goal. Marcotte's got to pull him down. As we see shot, fake a shot, go to the outside. And as he's centering this puck to Lafleur, Marcotte is pulling Lafleur down. Otherwise, Lafleur had that whole net. A good penalty taken by Marcotte to keep this game even and give the Boston penalty killers a chance to kill off this Montreal power play.
You're talking about the game being even at 10:09, a power play goal, Middleton from Cashman and Redmond. And then another power play goal, Lemaire from Savard on the point at 14:19. Here is the announcement of the penalty. So Scotty Bowman and his Chargers have a break here as we move into the final minutes of the first period. They can apply their power play, and toward that end, they're going to have Mondou, Lambert, that's Napier on the other side, Lafleur and Robinson, Boston, Milbury. He's seeing a lot of service out there in this first period, playing very well. Miller is on, Redmond and Rick Smith. Now it's back to Lambert. Lambert at the point over to Lafleur, winding up with a shot. And they hit him, and there's another shot. Mondou missed the open side. Into the corner is Robinson. Robinson trying to hand it off to Mondou. Robinson gloved it. Now it's back to the point. Lambert into Big Robinson. Robinson up on that left side. Gives it to Mondou. He's going to turn around. Will he take a shot? There it is, right onto the short side. Robinson or Rick Smith, they'll try and get a whistle to Bruins, but they can't. Napier behind the net, they want to put this in shot! And a Larson is saved by Gilbert with Mondou right on the lip of the crease. There's a shot by Redmond. He got in behind Lambert. And of course, Dryden had to be very sharp with the Canadians, a wave of four of them at center, into the corner. Lambert hustles in there. Oh, he was belted by Milbury. Here's Lafleur. Lambert is hurt. Lafleur over to Robinson. Robinson. Lambert is still on the ice.
Rick Smith touches it, and that was a tremendous jolt on Lombaert by Milbury.
Well, the crowd was booing because Lombaert was down. He hit his head on the glass, and the people felt that the referee should have blown the whistle. Montreal had possession of the puck, and it looked like Lombaert was getting up, so Bob Myers didn't want to stop the play, but he's definitely in a fog. He was taken in very heavily by Milbury, and because of it, he's still down there, probably could have lost consciousness or maybe even could get a concussion, a case like that, because your head hits that glass, and you're coming with that kind of speed, you really receive quite a hit.
That was some move. He didn't have much time to make a move, but he was quick on his reflex. I'm thinking of Gilbert on Montu.
That's right. As we look at Milbury, Milbury really giving him the shoulder, and a good clean check, no question about it, but Lombaert not in position to take it, hitting his head in the glass. Gilbert made just a fantastic save on that play. He went down and just threw his legs out. It's one of those saves where you say the puck's not in, you just got to gamble and go down, and he made a super save. And I'll have to say right now, Gilbert has been the dominant factor on the ice tonight. Here's the play as we see Montu setting up in front, taking a pass on the skates, back to his forehand, and just a great save by Gilbert as he was moving to his right but got it with his left hand.
So now we are ready for the resumption in play in the first period with a minute and 54 seconds left. Marcotte has 50 seconds remaining in his penalty. Scores tied at a goal. The Bruins get it to center. Robinson, Lafleur, Lapointe, Schutt, and Lemaire. Five Canadians at the line. Here's Schutt going in on goal. He's upended. And I would think that every Canadian supporter, the coach, and the Canadian players are convinced there should have been a penalty. But right now, you look at Scotty Bowman, who is not pleased, of course, over the fact that a penalty was not assessed against the Bruins. Face off to the right of Gilbert. 35 seconds left in the Marcotte penalty. Lafleur and Robinson on the point. Back to Lafleur. Lafleur, it was off the stick. Rick Smith failed it, clear it the first time. Knocked down by Lafleur. Lafleur clearing it in. It comes right in front of the net. Loose puck. And they get all mixed up in front of the net. They were in there very closely. And finally, the Bruins clear it down the ice. Montreal will have to hustle for another power play rush because Marcotte has 8 seconds left. Robinson dumped it delicately into the corner. Miller goes in there, off the boards. And Redmond propels it down on the right side, and that brings about an expiration in the penalty to Marcotte. So again, the Bruins held well, got some good saves, a few good saves by Gilbert. Now there are 51 seconds left in the opening period. Robinson takes over at his own line. They're watching each other very carefully right here. It's knocked off the point stick by Marcotte that goes over the board.
Well, even though the Canadians are working quite hard and they look like they have a significant edge in play, they are not sharp at all. You can tell by their passing around the net. Boston's doing a solid checking job on them, and as we see Larry Robinson there, he's awful tired, just working hard.
They seem very tight in around the net, the Canadians. They're not loose, and everything's getting mixed up in their
Danny,
skates.
They sure are.
40 seconds left. The Bruins won and the Canadians won. Rattel shooting it in. Schmott's on the move on the left side. Gainey gets a second shot at it, gives it to Jarvis. He shoots it to the corner. Sims fires it off the board. Bruins would like to get it out of here, out of their own zone. They pile in behind the net. And the face-off will be of Bruin territory. Réjean Houle is seeing a lot of service despite the fact that he's been out of the lineup for well over 3 weeks.
Well, Dan, Scotty elected to go with the cripples tonight. He's taken out Houle and Riseborough, who were out of the lineup with injuries, inserted them in the lineup. There's only three players off this club that played that seventh game series. You see Riseborough wearing that mask to protect that broken nose. And there's only three players that have that seventh game experience for the Canadians in here.
A mask like that, how much does it impede a player's proficiency?
Quite a bit. You lose sight of the puck in close to your feet.
Now, Canadians, everybody up for a big face-off. The Bruins getting it into the center ice area. And it is Savard handing it off to Robinson. Schmott's forechecking along with Marcotte and Rattel. They're going to play out the period with 2 seconds. It's cleared to the line, and that's the end of the period. Shots on goal 15-10 in favor of Montreal. And the scoring plays, Middleton for Boston and Lemaire for Montreal, both power play goals, and so the score at the end of the first period. The Bruins won and the Canadiens won. So we have Richel at center, Marcotte on one wing, and Schmotz on the other. Regent, Ould, Jarvis, and Gainey, and the Canadiens knife it in there, and they go into Bruin territory. Here is Gainey. Gainey getting it back to Sabre. There's the shot. It was screened. But eagle eye of Mr. Gilbert with a gloved hand. He was there to get it. So we have the Canadiens with their defense of Savard and Lapointe in over the line. But the Bruins get the draw and they hustle into the center ice area with Middleton firing it in. Savard going in there to take it away from Rattel. Middleton waiting for Cashman. He scores! What a beautiful move by Cashman.
Boy, he was all alone in back there, Lou, and I don't know if it was intended that way or the puck just got there, but he didn't waste any time at all, and the Bruins have a 2-1 lead.
Well, the puck got there from Rick Middleton going behind the net as both defensemen follow the puck. Lapointe's looking at the puck. Middleton's going to center it behind the net right there to Cashman, who comes out rather quickly, puts it between Dryden's legs, and gives the Bruins that lead. Here's Rattel making the forecheck, Middleton setting up the goal, and Cashman putting it away.
I don't think that was by happenstance. He came out so quickly, he had his mind made up what he was going to do all the way. Beautiful effort by Cashman.
Seconds, the time of the go-ahead goal by the Bruins, 2-1. They jam in on the boards outside the Boston line, recapping that play for you. Cashman for Middleton and Rattel, 27 seconds. So, Scotty Bowman.
Hey, he is chewing gum now. First time.
Face-off will be executed again to the right of Gilbert. The Bruins 2 and the Canadiens 1. Canadiens out shooting Boston 18-12. Lemaire will try to get it back to Savard if he can. Now it goes back to the other side to Lapointe. There's a shot wide. Shot try to get it in front. The Bruins on the left side get it out over the line. Lafleur gathering speed on his wrong wing. Over the line. Milbury is there as he is so often for the Bruins. Lemaire was upended. Here's Lafleur in the corner. Passing it back, Lemaire trying to center it, stopped by Gilbert. Rattel coming out over the line. There's the long lead pass, and Savard cleared it to the other side. Marcotte knocked it in behind the net, and now the Canadiens come out on the left side. Long shot to the corner by Schutz. Lafleur is bodied, gets it again, gives it to Lemaire. He's taken out the play by Rattel. And it's amazing the number of times you see Rattel, number 10, getting back to make a fine defensive play. A lot of people think of him only as an offensive player, but a good defensive one he is, number 10. Now the puck is back in Boston territory. Here's a shot by Gainey! And Gainey had a glittering opportunity as Gilbert gave him the puck. Now here's Schmotz going in. His shot goes off the leg of Engblom. Miller in the corner. Schmotz comes up with it. He's getting set. He fired it. And it went off Dryden wide. Luckily for Dryden, was on the short side. He was hugging that pipe. Here's Gainey up on the left wing. Into the corner. Gainey speeds. He centered it. Puck is loose. Now Jonathan from the corner for the Bruins down on the right wing at center. Harassing him is Gainey. It's cleared into Canadiens territory. The Bruins raced in there to do some forechecking. Now Robinson goes to the other side, up on the left side. It goes to Gainey, to Jarvis. Napier is coming up on the wing. It's swept in by Jarvis into the corner. Jonathan will get clear of it on the left side, but not out over the line. Regent Ould into Napier. Napier turning, getting it back. The Bruins fail to clear it out again. Robinson into Regent Ould. Ould flicked it, and it went over the glass. The Bruins 2 and the Canadiens 1. There's Robinson's pass stopped. It's kicked in over the line by Gainey. Milbury
around the net, out on the left side. Here is Engblom. Milbury again into the center ice area. Cashman's pass goes to an open wing. Now it's filled by Rattel. Rattel is on the wing. He lost it. Rattel staying with it. Now Cashman clearing it in. And Robinson is trying to get some skating room for the Canadians. Gets it out to Ganey. Back to Robinson. Engblom on the right side. He poked it ahead and it's over the glass. 13:29 left in the second period.
Canadians had 15 shots on goal in the first period. They've had only three in the first 6 minutes and 31 seconds of this second period. The Bruins likewise three in this second period. Overall right now, Montreal out shooting Boston 18-13, but where it really counts, the Bruins have the lead, 2-1.
Well, much of the emotion of the start of the game has subsided, and this is in the Bruins' favor. Coming out in the second period, all the crowd being much quieter than they were at the beginning, and Boston has picked up the tempo of this period.
And now we have Lemaire, Lafleur, and Schutt, the attacking line for Montreal, countering for the Bruins. Don Cherry as Miller, Jonathan, and Cashman. Rick Smith plays it over on the left side to Milbury. He shoots it in. Miller is in there watching Robinson rather closely, forward checking Marcotte also. He's on with Schmutz. So the Bruins have made some quick changes. Engblom in over the line. Here's Engblom. He held it too long. It was knocked off his stick. Robinson up on the left side to Lemaire. The Canadians are forced to take shots from well out. Now Engblom right in front of comes his shot. He fired it! And a splendid save by Gilbert. Oh, that was the save of the night. Schmutz shooting it! And he whipped his shot just wide. Oh, what a save that was by Gilbert. I want to see that leg action on the replay. Now it's Lafleur. He can't get anywhere against Sims. The Bruins clearing it in to Canadians' territory. Be successful in the playoffs, you have to get that great goaltending, and the Bruins have been getting it. There's a shot, a long one by Lemaire. Park into the corner against Lemaire. Lafleur in there trying to help up. And down on the ice is Park, and a face-off in Bruin territory.
Now the home crowd picks up the pace, Lou, as you look at the action leading to the penalty call.
And after this, you'll see Ganey coming into the picture, and Ganey giving a hard check right there in Rattel, and Rattel retaliated right there. And that cost 2 minutes for the Bruins, and the Montreal fans are very, very alive right now.
So we have Lemaire, Robinson, Lapointe, Savard, and Lafleur on the power play for Montreal. Milbury, Redmond, Smith, and Park. Now they fight for it in front of the net. It's Marcotte out there, not Park. The Bruins clearing it down the ice. Robinson back with Lafleur. Redmond and Marcotte up there for checking the defense of Smith and Milbury into the center ice area. And the Canadians led by Lafleur. Lafleur shooting it in. Four Montreal players move in. And it's over the corner glass. So that brings the penalty time remaining down to a minute and 35 seconds.
Well, Gilbert's got his shot down. A good move. He just fired it out over the glass. And in Boston, he wouldn't have been able to do that because they've got such high glass behind the net that that would have been kept in play. Good move by Gilly, though, to get it on the play and get a whistle here.
This is the third power play advantage for Montreal. Boston's at two. There's Lemaire. Right in front of Savard. He shoots it. Oh, what a stupendous move by Gilbert. Savard is right there.
What's the saying, Lou? You can't put it by him with a cannon?
That's right. He's just challenging the shooters at every occasion and beating them. And here it's Savard all alone in front trying to get it up and over him. But Gilly coming out just smothered him. A fine setup and a better play by Savard right here. He made a good move, tried to get it past Gilbert, but Gilbert made the save.
Now it's back to Lafleur. He's getting set, takes the shot, and a rising shot. And let's see, we're going to have two penalties about to be assessed, I think. The referee is skating over toward the penalty box. That's Bob Myers. We have Guy Lapointe going off, and Don Marcotte is going to join Rattel.
And if you're wondering why Cherry's upset, because you don't want to go from a 5-on-4 to a 4-on-3. Montreal now will have an added advantage, a 5% better advantage, but they've got more room to handle that puck. And Cherry does not like that call. It's much easier to kill off a penalty with 4 against 5 than 3 against 4.
You know, Scotty Bowman is using the two defensemen as wingers in the power play again, Lou, Savard and Lapointe. He has not done that all year. This is a first here tonight. Robinson on the point with Lafleur, and there's one of the defensemen who was up front. Lapointe is now in the penalty box, along with Rattel and now Marcotte.
That's right, Dick, and that might be one of the reasons. In case you're going to get a penalty, someone's going with him, and they're big and strong in front of the net to tie up the Bruin defensemen, and all you're going to get out of that are double penalties. And so the Canadians right now get an added advantage.
So let us see what will eventuate in this situation. Lemaire, Lafleur, Schott, and Robinson. Redmond, along with Rick Smith and Milbury, defending for the Bruins. And in the Rattel penalty, a minute and 16 seconds left, and the Canadiens going to the attack on the power play. Here's Lafleur in over the line with Schott. Lafleur puts on the brakes. Over it comes to Robinson. Robinson takes a look. Now Robinson working it into the side. It goes to Lemaire. It's slippery in front. A wild pileup. Gilbert is down. Gilbert is over there, and he is warning Schott.
And Larry Robinson trying to get his player out of there because another penalty right now will take away that advantage for a while.
On that play, Lou, Lemaire had the puck at the side of the net, and I felt he didn't get enough on the pass as he tries to get it across to Lafleur, tried to ease it across, flipped it rather, and the puck never did get to Lafleur, and Gilbert covered up in the play.
That's right, it seemed to carry him off Steve Schott right there in front of the net, and into Gilbert, had it gone by, Lafleur coming in, racing from the outside, was all alone, he could have slammed it home. Here's the pass, trying to go across, but he got it off the heel of his stick.
There's a look at the action.
Fifty-nine seconds left in the Rattel penalty. That's the amount of power play time the Canadians have.
And the puck is dropped. Robinson, the long reach. He poked it to the side. He and Smith go after it. Now it goes to Lemaire, to Lafleur. Lafleur back to Lemaire, over the other side to Robinson. Back to Lafleur. Lafleur keeping it in at the point. Over to Robinson. The Canadians passing it back and forth. Some of their passes are not too good, but they retain possession. Here's Lafleur shooting it. It's blocked. Into the corner goes to Lemaire. And we're having a couple of more penalties. Or just
Steve Schott. He's going to get a cross-checking call as he flattens Smith in front of the net. And there goes the Canadiens' power play edge with 32 seconds left of the penalty to Jean Rattel. They'll now play four aside. This Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Forum in
face-off outside the Canadiens' line. The Bruins with the advantage here. They have Redmond, Middleton, Rattel, and Perry. Savard chopped it down on the left side. Lemaire and Robinson are the other defenders to the Canadiens. Now Brad Perry. He's the big man on the power play. He slides the pass over to Redmond. Redmond takes a look in front of goal. Rattel almost deflected it in there. And Dryden came up with a great maneuver. Getting that puck between his pads.
He's saved by Kenny Dryden, Lou. Comes just as the penalties to Lapointe and Marcotte expired, so shuts alone in the penalty box. Here it is.
Well, Rattel made a fine play just getting that puck out of the air. He tried to change direction of it as he was being checked. Dryden was close enough so that when he makes the save, even though the puck had changed direction through Rattel's deflection right there, he was able to stop it and cover up. And as you said right now, the Canadiens one man short, but it's 5 against 4.
From the faceoff, back it goes to Redmond. Over to Park, he winds up, and he rattled that one off Ganey's leg. Now Park going in there. Into the corner, goes to Cashman. He tried to center it. Savard coming up with it for Montreal. Here is Savard down on the right side. Savard dragging the puck, gives it to Ganey. Over for Jarvis, and he missed that pass. Now Middleton giving it to Park. On the left side. Redmond ahead into the center ice area to Middleton. Middleton is over the line, trying to clear it in. He gets it to Rattel. Right here in front it comes. Here's Clark, and he failed to kick it up. Ganey down on the left side. Ganey cutting it over the line. Now he put on the brakes, killing off seconds. In the penalty, a half dozen seconds left, and there's an offside call at the Boston line.
Boy, some pretty good covering up by that Montreal defense, Lou, right there with that net wide open.
Well, Dick, I'm telling you, Brad Parr's going to be thinking like Stan Jonathan, what do I have to do to get in that open net? Steve Shutt just serving the remainder of the penalty time, 5 seconds. But the Bruins with a great chance. Dougie Jarvis coming back to help out. Brad Parr not being able to control the puck and put it in the open net, so the score remains 2-1.
Immediately following this hockey telecast, viewers in British Columbia will get up-to-the-minute results of the BC provincial election. The CBC's news team provides full coverage with anchorman Bill Good Jr. The computers are standing by. Stay tuned to CBC British Columbia.
5 seconds left, and the Shutt penalty is getting set to come back on. Now he is back on the ice, and there's an offside call. So we have 7:10 left in the second period. 2-1 the score. Boston leading, and the Bruins got the tiebreaker in this period. Cashman getting it.
Well, to tell you what this game means to the state of Massachusetts and the city of Boston, the other night when the Bruins were playing the Canadiens and they announced the score at Fenway Park, when it was 4-2, they got a thunderous ovation, and 5-2, they got a standing ovation.
And if they win this one and go home, what's going to happen then? In it goes into Montreal territory. Lapointe feeding it up on the left side. Shutt with Lemaire. Lafleur is trailing on the play. Now he's coming in over the line. The Bruins trying to get possession. It's on the board. Marcotte hands it off to Miller. On the other side, Smott. He dropped it back in there. Here's Marcotte. Dropping it back, and it's intercepted by Lemaire with Lafleur. Lafleur off the board. He felt it. Hilberry got a piece of him. Lafleur remained upright, but he couldn't pick up the puck. Engblom is going in. They chop away at it, and it's back into the center ice area. 6 minutes and 20 seconds left. Second period. Good move by Engblom. A poke from Hilberry, but cleared it in. Puck is knocked down in midair by Rajan. Oh, Milbury winds it along the boards to the left side. Canadians keeping it in. Smott played it too long. Condor backhand shot. Now Napier trying to get it in front. And the Bruins clear it into the center ice area. You saw Smott wait a bit too long there. And Condor almost cashed in. Rajan, oh, he's upended by McNabb. Smott is hit by Robinson. Now on the right side, in over the line. Here's Rajan going in, firing it! And the angle was sharp, and he missed with a fairly hefty drive. Now Jonathan back for Boston. Jonathan going in, riding out of the net. Excellent action here as we move into the final 5 minutes of the second period. Lombard comes off the bench and cleared it to Mondou. Back to Lombard. Lombard at center. He was knocked off balance by O'Reilly. And Savard, who has played a tremendous game for the Canadians, gives it to Robinson. There's Big Robinson going into the corner. McNabb very coolly cleared it back into the center ice area. Savard up on the left side. A deflection by Lombard. Now it's loose. Finally, O'Reilly picking his way out. A good move to get by Rice. Lombard shooting it! Rob Lombard. O'Reilly missed it. There's a shot by Lombard. And this Gilbert is something else. He reminds me of Johnny Bauer back. Here's Jonathan. Out of the net is Dryden. Jonathan in behind the net. Dryden is crawling back into the net. And Jonathan never did get a pass in front. Now they poke away at it at the side of the net. And the Canadians survived that close call. Risebrough and McNabb into the boards. The play is stuck.
Some tremendous action, Lou. First off, great goaltending by Gilbert.
Well, Lambert was robbed twice, but this time right there, he had the shot where he wanted. Gilbert still got a piece of it. And as the Bruins came down the ice after this save by Gilbert, Jonathan had an open net and Dryden was way out, but Jonathan never took the shot. Watch Dryden scramble. He's scrambling on all fours trying to get back, and Jonathan can't get a shot at the net, and he's trying to set someone up.
I started to mention this is reminiscent of 64 when Bauer, in a seventh game,
eliminated the Canadiens personally with tremendous saves, and Gilbert making those kinds of saves here in this second period particularly. Cashman going in on that right side. Cleared into the corner. Rattel is trying to tie up his man. Here's Cashman. Middleton is in front. Cashman is trying to get set. He scores! And what a goal! Cashman is second of the period.
Boy, I'll tell you, both goals by Wayne Cashman, Lou, in this period have shown that experience can pay off in a situation like this.
Well, Dick, he has to be one of the comeback players of the year. Cashman had an outstanding season. He comes around, he takes a shot using the screen, he gets a short side. He was looking to pass it at first as he goes behind the net. He's looking up a couple times right here again, and now he's going to just shoot it. And it catches a short side. When things are going right for you and you're hot, they count. And the Bruins are just playing with a great deal of enthusiasm right now.
So Wayne Cashman from Rattel and Middleton at 16-12 into the second period. There you are, Lou. Describe
that's,
this.
That's right. Cashman just turned around and shot, and Dryden seemed to be bothered a little bit with the people in front, but it still went in on the short side, up high over his shoulder, and that's Cashman right there, the hero for the Bruins thus far, along with Gilbert.
So the Bruins leading 3-1. Here's shot going in. He was checked effectively by Sims. In on the boards. They fight for it. Savard is keeping it in. It's off the leg. The Bruins. Miller clearing it to Schmatz into the center ice area. Lemaire getting it to Savard to Robinson. Robinson at the line up on the right side. Shutters across the line, dropping it back to Lemaire. He whipped it off the corner boards. Marcotte against Lafleur. Robinson fails to keep it in. And Savard back to his own line, gives it to Robinson. Four Canadians led now by Lemaire on the right side. He dropped it back. Narcotte was there in front of Lafleur and cleared it out. And a high degree of tenacity in the checking of the Bruins right now, because they have a two-goal lead. And they do not wish to give up a goal to the Canadiens in the remaining 2 minutes and 50 seconds in this period. There's Gainey whipping a shot. Mondeau twisting and turning. Robinson is trying to get in front. It's centered. It goes off a leg. And Marcotte playing it ahead. Boxes over the line, gives it to McNabb, and it was just too far for McNabb. Now Lapointe laying it up on the left side. Rick Smith is back at the line. The Bruins have three goals. The Canadiens one. Réjean Houle clearing it in. Rick Smith shooting it down. And the pattern of the Bruins game has changed completely since they got a two-goal ball. They're doing an amazing job right here of checking. They're right on top of the Canadiens. There's O'Reilly giving it to Middleton. Middleton takes the shot. Wait, it's good! And McNabb deflected it wide. O'Reilly trying to get it in front. Here is McNabb. McNabb is getting set for the shot. It's blocked. And now the Bruins going to the attack. Here's Middleton shooting it. And Lapointe was in front of it. And the Bruins were all over the Canadiens. Now the Canadiens coming back. O'Reilly turning at his own line. A minute and 35 seconds left in the second period. Middleton over the line. Here's O'Reilly. And Risebrough cleared at the center. Arc to O'Reilly. In it goes to Rattel. Rattel on the backhand. And he fired it wide. He is quite a backhand. There's O'Reilly right in front. Tremendous pressure here by the Bruins. Lou, when they got that two-goal lead, they were right on top of the Canadiens. Then when they got the opportunity to win there, they kept tremendous pressure on Montreal.
Well, since they've got that two-goal lead, they've increased the tempo. They've taken over the whole game. Instead of Montreal coming out and fighting back, this has been all Bruins right now. And that was a great save on O'Reilly and a good comeback by Risebrough to pull him down and bother him. But just the effort of the Bruins to forecheck, to stay on the puck, has created numerous opportunities right here. And they just seem to smell victory. They're just like a tiger after its prey. They know they've got it, and they're going after it.
It's cliche to say that they're fired up, and I think that's their condition.
That's right, and right now, Montreal's getting four people up ice quite a bit, and they're going to get caught with just one man back.
A minute and 18 seconds left in the second period. Now Cashman, a great star, gives it to Park. Drifts the shot. Lafleur got rid of it. It's right to a Bruin, Marcotte, and it's cleared in again. Cashman moving in with Rattel and Marcotte to do some forechecking. 1 minute left in the second period. Here's Savard. Down on the right side with Lambert. Jarvis over the line. It's blocked by a leg. Cleared out over the line. And Lafleur is back after. Gives it to Robinson. Robinson up on the wing. Jarvis is offside. How about conditioning? Now, I mentioned earlier that there was the consensus of a lot of people in that sixth game in Boston that Gainey, Robinson, and Savard particularly looked jaded near the end of the game. How about in this game? They've worked hard tonight going into that third period.
Well, both clubs are working hard, and if there's anything that could have been a little telling difference, today it was cool in Montreal. If it was hot, the Bruins would have even more advantage because the ice would have been slow, but the Bruins seemed to be every bit as strong as the Canadiens, even though the day was cool, the buildings, you know, at a good temperature compared to what it was in Boston the other night. Yet the Bruins just sense victory, they sense the kill, and they're going after it.
Now it's Park at the line. Here's Milbury. On the left side, he shuffled it ahead to Miller, who scooped it in. Now it goes to the other side. Lafleur over skating it and then getting it to Robinson. Robinson starting out with 23 seconds left in the second period, gives it to Savard. Savard has been a tremendous workhorse for the Canadiens in this game so far. At the line, back into the corner it goes. Park is bumped by Lafleur. Here is Schutt. Passing it back, Robinson is going the other way. And that will be the end of the scoring threat of the Montreal Canadiens for this second period, because now we have 2 seconds. That's the end of 2 periods. And the third period has just got underway. 3-1 Boston. The Bruins go into the Canadian zone and Lafleur pokes it ahead on the right side. Rick Smith and Lafleur jam it against the boards. 15 seconds have gone by, and they give us an opportunity now to tell you that the shots on goal in that second period, 12-10 for Montreal. Canadian high for the night is Mondeau with 4, and for the Bruins, we have Jonathan with 3 and Cashman with 3. So it's Robinson in there. He's bumped by Spots. Ahead it goes to Schutt. Schutt, the rink-wide pass to Lemaire. Lemaire over the line. An high shot that was rising. And Gilbert going down, grabbed it and held on. Jarvis against Rattel. Now here's Engblom trying to get it into the corner. He was jammed under the play by Rattel to the other side. Middleton playing it back. Risebrough tipped it in front. Rattel knocked it to the wing. There's Savard on it. Into the corner, Sims. He clears it ahead. Schmatz has it. He's onside. Schmatz over the line. Over for Middleton, and it went by Middleton. Middleton trying to make the move by Engblom. Here's Rattel, the old smoothie, into the corner. Schmatz, he centered it. It comes to the lip of the crease, and Savard cleared it away. Jarvis and Rattel struggling for possession. To the other side, it goes to Risebrough. Bruins keep it in. Up on the right side it goes, and finally into the center ice area. Now Sims playing it down on the left side. We're nearing the 5th minute mark into the third period. Boston leading by 2, 3-1. Rattel gives it to Schmatz. He shoots it in. Marcotte trying to knock down a clearing pass from Dryden. Here's Lafleur. Lafleur left wing pass to Schutt. Schutt going in, a goal! He fired it, and Gilbert came out. But Schutt was in a little too deeply. Now O'Reilly. O'Reilly played it ahead, and Robinson wheels back for the Canadiens. Doesn't get very far. Here's Lapointe shooting it into the corner. Lafleur on the move, it goes to the other side. Lapointe bumping just gently along the boards with Milbury. Now here's Lafleur. He centered it, it comes right into the crease again. Gilbert is down.
14:58 remaining in regulation time. The Bruins leading 3-1.
And the attendance, 17,453. Now Mondeau bounces to the corner, centers it. Cashman, the wily veteran, clearing it into the center ice area. Here's Robinson. A pass broken up by Cashman.
coming in with McNabb back to Middleton. It's centered right in front. Now it's behind the net. Here's Middleton trying to get it in on the short side. Finally, Mondeau cleared it behind the net. Close call there for the Canadians is Trombley on the right wing. He's trying to move through, and McNabb played it over on an open right wing. Robinson ahead. Bombear banking it in for Mondeau. Mondeau pumps Sims. Bombear into the corner. Sims chopped it to the other side. Trombley will be on it there. Trombley centering it. It comes to the side. Hart giving it to Cashman. He can't clear it out. Now Cashman starts up on the right side. Middleton, a pass over for McNabb, and the Canadians on the right side. Lafleur. Lafleur cutting. Lafleur from the corner. He swings it right over the net. Well, Lafleur's Lafleur, and that's to put it plainly. Lafleur did it all. He came up the ice with full speed. They left the puck for him. And as he was circling around behind the net, Montreal's going through a line change. See them coming off the bench. And so Lafleur holds it long enough till Napier gets in position right in the slot. A pass, a shot, a score. And the lead is now only one goal. Here's Lafleur as we see the people coming off the bench. He holds it long enough, circles the net. And here's the pass out, right out front, right in the slot to Napier, and he puts it home.
So the Canadians right back into the thick of things. Napier on the move, and he bumps Milbury. It's cleared on the right side. Now on the boards, Engblom, lighting the slot. Here's Napier. Napier around the net, traffic in front of the net. Lafleur. Lafleur has it in center. Back to Engblom. There's a shot. Gilbert out of the net. Lafleur trying to center it again. It's knocked down by Schwartz. He's bumped by Engblom. Here come the Bruins, but that was a glove pass and it's called back.
A pretty quiet crowd here since that goal by Cashman early in the second period, but I tell you, this place has erupted. 3-2, and now the home team trails by just one. And there's Mark Napier. Well, one of the keys there, not only the big play by Lafleur in the setup, but Napier just drilled it as soon as it got to him, and that's what he had to do.
That's right. Gilbert was moving across quickly, and Napier just put it on the net, and actually he just shot it for any spot on the net and hit the opening. Gilbert couldn't do anything about it. Mark Napier really makes it a bedlam place to be sitting in right now in the Montreal Forum.
6-10, the time of the goal. Lafleur and Trombley on the assist.
Now Robinson over to LaPointe. There's the shot. And down on the ice, Redmond, a pall of gloom was starting to envelop the Forum. But that goal has brought these Canadian supporters back in a lively fashion.
Well, Dick Redmond did what a defenseman should do at that time. Just catch the shot yourself, freeze it, because the goalie can't see it.
Now the Bruins. There's the shot by Lemaire. Redmond clearing it off the glass is down the ice. Jonathan going after it. Robinson strides back for Montreal. 12 minutes and 55 seconds left in regulation time. Here's Lemaire going in. Redmond coming out of the play. Penalty coming up against Redmond. And the Bruins are infuriated.
And Cherry's just standing on the bench going wild. He's saying to the crowd, you got your wish, bowing towards the referee. The Bruins didn't need a penalty at this time.
Well, all right, the old story, judge for yourself. The penalty call is against Redmond.
It was the speed of Lemaire that actually created the penalty, because he was going free on the outside and Redmond had to get position. And the referee called it. It was a very close call, but he called it, and it's right now an advantage for Montreal.
So any time a player gets that stick and, you know, puts it in the middle of the midsection, then he's in a little bit of trouble. This is Stanley Cup 79 from the Forum.
Lafleur along the boards, getting it back to Lemaire. Lemaire winds up with a shot, and a ricocheted wide. Now into the corner, here's Lafleur taking a shot, a rising shot. Big pressure by the Canadians, but the Bruins relieve it for the nonce at least. They clear it down on the right side. Schmott's in on the boards. He would love to have been able to get a whistle against Lafleur there, but the Canadians start out on the power play.
Here's Ganey. Ganey is over the line. He's forced to come back. Savard is stranded in Boston territory. Now Ganey, twisting and turning in the center ice area. Over to Savard, back in for Ganey. Here's Savard, shooting it, knocked down by Park. It went by LaFleur. Here's LaFleur, taking a look. LaFleur, Park has lost his stick. Ganey around the net to LaFleur at the side. Here's LaFleur, getting it back. LaPointe winds up. Oh!
Lou, you can take the replay. I hope the folks at home can hear you, because I don't think I will be able to.
Well, watch LaFleur. He knows that he's got no one in front to pass it to, so he looks up and spots LaPointe. LaPointe shoots through traffic, and then he uses the screen, and he gets that shot on the short side. A fine shot. It might have been deflected in front of that. You can't tell, but it was the screen of Gilbert that allowed LaPointe to put it in.
You know, Lou, the fella that was providing the screen was Savard. The boys talked about that in the intermission, about why Scotty Bowman was sending Savard and LaPointe up front. They're big. They can't be pushed out of the way. Ganey in there as well. Well, there's LaPointe, who scored the tying goal. And it's 3-3. LaPointe from LaFleur and Ganey at 8:16.
And so with the score tied at 3 goals, 11 minutes and 37 seconds left in regulation time, O'Reilly clearing it up on the right side. McNabb lost it. Lambert with Napier. Lambert shooting it. Gilbert way out of the net. Nobody heard the whistle.
Boy, he could not have seen Napier. He was all alone behind the Boston defense to Lambert's right side.
Oh. Boy, Dick, it looked like Napier was going to just cruise in for a breakaway in this play as Lambert breaks in and just shoots with his head down. Here comes Napier, and that's Mike Milbury on the ice without a helmet. I don't know if he just discarded it or threw it away. He's never gone without a helmet, do we know him? Quite a competitor out of Colgate University, that Mike Milbury.
I see he's playing without his helmet.
Yeah, we just
you mentioned that already, have you?
Right.
He got involved with Savard there, I don't know. Maybe a strap broke.
Or he just might have thrown it away after the goal.
Now there's a shot. Rajan, oh, shoots it again! Big save by Gilbert. The second shot, Ganey missing it. Ganey had an opportunity to direct it on the open side right in front of the crease. Now the Bruins clearing it down the ice. Rajan Ouellet had two excellent scoring opportunities, and Ganey won. And the Canadians have taken the play away from the Bruins, and Montreal starting out again. The point down on the right side. Jammed in on the boards. Milbury clearing out to Marcotte. Up it goes to the Canadians' line. Ganey lost it. Marcotte is over the line. Gives it to Brad Park. And it's called on the offside.
And what a game for our big audience in Canada and also our NHL network in the United States.
Quite a promotion, isn't it, for the finals that'll be coming up?
I suppose this is going all the way to Minnesota, isn't it?
We have hockey all over the country.
Bruins, everybody up for the face-off. There is Middleton chasing it. Middleton getting it back. Park fanned on it. And Middleton cleared it up on the right side. He struggles in over the Canadiens' line. Here's Middleton digging into the corner against LaPointe. Score is tied at 3 goals. O'Reilly jammed in on the boards by Jarvis. Middleton looking for a loose puck, but the whistle did not go. Some of the players thought it did. Here's Rajan Ouellet going in on that left side. Going in, takes the shot. He didn't get much on it, and then Sims cleared the rebound over the net.
Boy, I'll tell you, Al Sims' move, Lou, in clearing the rebound was a gutsy move, because that puck was net high, and he knocked it out of the air over the open net. That was a close call.
Just going up and over the crossbar, right, as the speed of Ouellet almost breaks him away. He does go to his backhand to get a shot away, and here's Sims as he's sliding into the net. He knocked it over the glass. You know, that was all started because the players thought they heard a whistle. Everybody relaxed, and the Canadians almost got a breakaway on the play.
Now they are arguing the point, I think, right now. Rattel and Bobby Schmatz with linesman John D'Amico prior to this faceoff in the Boston zone to the right. 8:08 remaining in regulation time. The Bruins 3, the Canadians 3 in this game 7 of the semifinal.
Rattel is at center, Schmatz on one wing. Mark Cott is out there because he saw Lafleur go on. Now Lafleur has gone back to the bench. Chartrand, Jarvis, and Gainey up front. Engblom and Savard on the points. And the referee is adamant that there will be no more changes. He points with authority. Score tied at 3 goals on the faceoff. Rattel gives it to Smith. Smith around the net. Drops it off. Milbury clearing it into the center ice area. Rattel shooting it back in. Now to the far side for Chartrand. Chartrand ahead to Jarvis. Gainey is moving up on the play. Gainey going into the corner, bumping rather vigorously with Milbury. Rattel takes over, clearing it up on the right side. It's fed back in by Engblom. Engblom again jostling on the boards with Schmatz. Rattel tries to tie up Jarvis. They might get a whistle. They do.
This Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Forum in Montreal.
And he knows he's going to have to go with 3 defensemen the rest of the way, and I'm sure the Bruins know this. And if I'm the Boston Bruins right now, you have to throw the puck in, make the Montreal Canadian defense work and tire, and hope that you can get a break, because you can't replace a guy like Lapointe. And because of the pace of the game up to this stage, those people have to be feeling the effects of a hard-fought game all game long.
Now there's Larry Robinson, who will be one of the players who will be feeling the brunt of it in these last few moments of this hockey game. Now we seem to be set to resume play. Savard has been absolutely outstanding tonight for Montreal, and he too will see a lot of ice. Okay, Danny.
And so play is on again, 4:39 left in regulation time, score tied at 3. Now Park banks it off the boards into the center ice area. Robinson feeding it back in, and the Canadians in there to apply pressure. They've had a lot of pressure on the Bruins in the third period. Now Boston coming out, led by Park. Park hitting that line. He rolls it in there, it's off the leg, and there's Savard. Ahead it goes, the Bruins taking over, clearing it ahead. Here's Middleton. Middleton trying to roll it in front. It was blocked by Savard. Now Rattel. Here's Middleton around the net, jamming up. He scores! Middleton, persistent, paid off there.
3 minutes and 59 seconds left in regulation time, and the Bruins, who were caught, have now regained the lead. Lou, those goals from back of the net have been big for Boston.
And the same type of goal as Cashman's goal. Middleton getting the puck behind the net. He comes around and he has to really wheel that puck on his backhand on the short side. And Dryden is coming across down somewhat, and it actually seemed to carry him off part of his body right into the net.
So the Bruins taking the lead at 4-3. Late in the third period, they go to the attack again. 3 minutes and 45 seconds left, and Milbury clearing it in. Rattel, number 10, into forecheck along with Schmatz and Marcotte. They're going to dry up the Canadians before the Canadians can utilize that great speed of theirs. Now Montreal starting out. They're broken up at center. Milbury ahead. Schmatz is bodied by Langway at the line. Langway, number 17, is on for Montreal. Here come the Canadians. Engblom down on that right side. He's at the line. It's shot back to center. And you're going to see a tremendously tenacious checking job by the Boston Bruins from here in. Whether they can hold out the Canadians is going to make for a very thrilling finish. Now Gainey keeping it in. There's a shot. It's wide. It's centered. Marcotte clearing it ahead. Cashman is chasing it into the center ice area. Now Cashman along the boards with Miller. Mondu, a pass that goes to an open wing. It's gobbled up and cleared in by Smith. And the Bruins are making changes while the play goes on. So are the Canadians. Here's Big Robinson, the pass. Ahead it goes. In over the line for Napier. And it was called on the offside. Napier didn't hear that whistle, neither did many of the people who are in this building. Let's see.
Well, they were calling the Bruins for too many men on the ice. The Bruins got caught in a
line changed the wrong way, and they're going to be penalized at this time, a very significant penalty.
Well, this is a terribly inopportune time for the Boston Bruins to pick up a penalty of that nature and of that magnitude at this time, as you say, with 2 minutes and 34 seconds remaining. And they're that far away from winning this series with a goal lead, but there's going to be an application of tremendous pressure by the Canadians now as they go all out to get that tying goal.
Well, we'll now see if the gutty Boston Bruins hockey team, a very fine hockey club, the club that's risen to the occasion so often in the past, can do it again right now, because the Montreal Forum will be rocking as the Bruins get penalized for too many men on the ice with 2:34 to go and leading by 1-4.
There's Scotty Bowman having words with his captain, Savard. The stratagem that they talk about now, I suppose, is basic and fundamental, Lou. Get in there and pour it on.
Well, Scotty called a timeout, a good move to give his people some rest, because Robinson was already on there, and so was LaFleur, and he wants to have them on right from the start of this power play. He's giving them some rest, telling them what he wants to do. You can bet that these two forwards and also the defenseman will be in front of the net screening and trying to cause some confusion to get a screenshot in on Gilbert, as it has been done twice tonight.
Savard, after talking to Bowman, went down and talked to Dryden. You think even with 2 minutes or more, if they get deep in Boston territory, they may lift the goalie?
Well, it will all depend on what kind of opportunities they're getting. Maybe down around the 50-second mark remaining in the period while the power play is still on, he might call them over, because they can't be called for icing anyway, being a man short.
So let us pick up the power play alignment now for the Montreal Canadiens. Lemaire, Gainey, Savard, Robinson, and LaFleur. Redmond, Park, Marcotte, and Milbury defending. There's LaFleur going in. LaFleur putting on the brakes, takes the backhand shot, the rebound. It's cleared but not out. Now Redmond snaps it down the ice. That puck was dangerously bouncing in that area in front of Gilbert, and Bill Redmond came up with it. Now the Canadians out over the line, Lemaire on the right side, LaFleur and Gainey moving in to pick up the shot off the boards, back to Robinson, and he whistles a shot just wide. Lemaire clearing it in, Milbury has lost his stick. Now it's back at the point. Robinson clearing it to Gainey. Back it goes to Robinson. They keep it in. It almost came out. In behind the net, Gainey. Gainey falls. Here's Lemaire around the net. He centered it. Redmond going to the boards with Robinson. They struggle frantically, and they get a stoppage of play. 1:06 left in the penalty.
Yes, the first word to any adventure. But when allergies and congestion strike, take Allegra D, a non-drowsy antihistamine plus a powerful decongestant, so you can always say yes to putting your true colors on display. Say yes to Allegra D.
It's a small finger, a worm.
Like a dagger.
Tiny sword.
Breadstick.
Matchstick.
A lamppost.
Coin slot! No.
10 seconds.
A stick, a walking stick.
Yeah,
a battery. Mount Kilimanjaro.
Sorry. It's a tandem bicycle.
What?
As long as sloths are slow, you can count on Geico saving folks money. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Hockey is preparing students for the fastest growing careers through Future Goals, the largest online program teaching students science, technology, engineering, and math. With lessons drawn from the game, students learn the dynamics behind the action as they take their team on an exciting journey to win the Stanley Cup without ever leaving the house. Keep your students sharp at home. Get free online access at nhl.com/futuregoals.
At the game remaining, 4-3 for Boston. The Canadians on the power play with 1:06 to go on the power play, 1:40 to go in the game.
So I would think before the penalty ends that Dryden, if there's a face-off deep in that zone, will be taken up. The penalty will expire to 1926. Now that will mean, if they do that, that they'd have to lift Dryden with perhaps over a minute to go.
Well, that's right, Dan. I think they will call him too, as we see a timeout called by Boston right now. Cherry trying to give his penalty killers a rest. Rick Smith, who's been doing yeoman service on defense. Marcotte and Schmutz, who have killed the penalty all night long. along with Brad Park. They're getting a rest, give Gilbert a rest, try and calm down the Montreal people so that they don't continue to cheer to get their hockey club up. Montreal pouring on the pressure right now, and it's going to be a good rest for the Bruins to take this 30 seconds. Savard just talking over there with LaFleur and Scotty, telling them what he wants done.
Well, there you have the entire season wrapped up in that scene where they're getting together to plan an attack that will give them the goal to keep their hockey lives going for this year.
Well, a hockey club noted for scoring goals, the Montreal Canadiens have to get one now. And a hockey club noted for tight checking, the Boston Bruins have to stop one now. Boston has been short five times, the Canadiens short three times.
So for the faceoff to the right of Gilbert, we have Lemaire, Schutt, Savard, LaFleur, and Robinson. The Bruins getting the draw. Brad Park fanned on it, failed to clear it out. It's centered right in front. Now Park takes a look and he shoots it down the ice. 55 seconds left in the penalty, a minute and 27 seconds left in regulation time. Boston 4, Montreal 3. LaFleur coming out rather gingerly on the right side. He gives it into Lemaire, back to LaFleur. Oh!
What could be more appropriate if anybody's going to score for the Canadiens than their gunner, Guy LaFleur, as he takes that drop pass after he had initiated the play. He beats Gilbert with a hard slap shot from the right side, low and on the far side. Guy LaFleur sends his place into a frenzy again.
Well, this is going to be heartbreaking for the Boston Bruins. The first two games of the series in here, they played very well. And everything went against them late in the game. They lost both. Here tonight, they saw a 3-1 lead wiped out. Then they came back. They took the lead. And a bench penalty, of all things, caused the loss of the lead again.
Well, Guy LaFleur put it just inside the pipe. What a great goal scorer he is. And he capitalized on the opportunity to drop pass from Lemaire. But these Boston Bruins haven't quit all year. They haven't quit tonight, and I don't think they're out of it now. We don't know who's going to win, but here's the drop pass and a shot by LaFleur sending this game into the overtime. Unless somebody scores with a minute 14 to go.
Well, that was a well-executed goal. You see LaFleur, the lead pass up to Lemaire. Lemaire in over the line, dropping it back. And then LaFleur, he has tremendous power in his shot.
Well, the Bruins might be a little down, but they aren't quitting right now. And you have to expect that anybody that gets an opportunity right now to win this game, and you might see it open up a little bit.
And you also might see overtime.
Exactly. LaFleur now leading all playoff scores with 8 goals, 2 in the power play.
So a minute and 14 seconds left in regulation time. 4-4. Rattel, Cashman, and Jonathan. Jonathan shooting it in, and the Bruins go to the attack. Here's Cashman centering it. Robinson takes over. He gives it to LaFleur. LaFleur shooting it. Oh! He didn't miss by much. Gilbert missed it, but the puck was wide. What a booming blast that was from outside the line by LaFleur. Here's Rattel. And it was gloved. And that's the reason why the play was stopped. What a touch.
Well, it wasn't touched by Rattel. With 48 seconds to go, Rattel knew that the puck was gloved, and he was waiting for one of his players, a fellow that actually knocked it down with his glove, to come and play. The referee, or the linesman, thought he was going to touch it, so he blew the whistle. There's LaFleur beating Gilbert, but missing the net just before, previous to that, Dryden had misplayed a puck behind the net, and the Bruins almost scored. So both goaltenders have to be a little edgy. And Buchanan has tied this game. Guy LaFleur still on the ice.
47 seconds left. Here's Gainey struggling to come in, and he's bodied by Marcotte. Smuts coming up on the right side. Shoots it in there. Dryden clearing it off to Savard. Savard wheeling away with 33 seconds left. He's at center. They shoot it in. And Montreal making changes now while the play goes on. Robinson tipped it back to the corner. What a series these two teams have had. Here's Robinson on the backhand. And the Bruins starting out on the right wing.
Smuts couldn't pick up that pass. Had he picked it up, he would have been able to get in there, and you know he has a great shot. Now it's down the ice. Could be icing here. And that favors Boston, but there's just 3 seconds left. And if I were a betting man, I'd say overtime.
Well, I would too, Danny, but I have seen games won in the last second off a faceoff right here. All they need to do is get the draw cleanly and a shot on net. I've seen him score at the 1959 mark.
Peter Mahovlich did it here one night with the score 0-0, Toronto and Montreal. Puck was iced. 3 seconds left. He put it into the net at 1959.
Well, in the Allen Cup playoffs, I saw Johnny Alfredani 1 year score for the Greyhounds against Owen Sound in senior hockey. So it's been done, and it could be done here.
Well,
you know that the Bruins are going to have to go with a left-handed centerman probably, so the puck comes back in the slot area. We're going to see who's going to take the shot.
Well, why wouldn't the Bruins take out their goalie?
Well, you still have time to get the draw clean and put it down there.
3 seconds?
3 seconds. It takes just 1 second to drop, and that puck can go the length of the ice in 2 seconds.
Okay, Bruins, everybody up, and it's going to be overtime. Score tied at 4, the end of regulation. And this has been another highly interesting
credit evaluation and game plan.
Faceoff outside the line. Now here's Milbury over on the right side to Cashman, broken up by Gainey. Gainey coming down over the line. There's the shot. It goes off Gilbert. Milbury cleared it on the left side. Rattel having difficulty. He's helped by Middleton, who clears it to the side of his own net. Gainey goes down. Here are the Bruins. A long pass ahead for Middleton over the line. Savard is after him. Takes him in on the boards. Robinson fishes it out and gets it up to Gainey at center. Gainey gives it to Jarvis over the line. Here's Jarvis on the backhand. He was falling, and he couldn't get it on the target, and he didn't have too much on the shot. Lafleur is on the ice. Canadian shot, trying to shut it, get it over in front. Cashman cleared it to center. Lafleur, who was the big offensive star of the third period for the Canadiens, shot it in. The Bruins return it down on the left side. And this is going to be icing against Boston. A minute and 14 seconds have gone by in the overtime. So they made a mistake in calling that icing on the appeal by the Canadians, or rather by the Bruins, and the faceoff. When it is an errant call, the faceoff goes to the center circle. Here is Park ripping it in on the right side. Big McNabb going in after Savard. Now Lafleur into the corner he goes. Got away from McNabb. Shot is up on the left side. Takes the pass. Cleared it to center. Marcotte feeding it back in, and the Bruins move in, led by O'Reilly. Savard ahead to shot. Here's Lafleur in full flight, but he couldn't get anywhere against McNabb. Here's McNabb getting a break. McNabb, oh, Robinson! What a play Robinson pulled up. There's a shot right off! And it was on that corner. It's centered in front. Now it's back. There's a shot! And a great save by Dryden on Marcotte. Oh, what glorious scoring opportunity the Bruins had. They had a chance to put it away. Now they're back at center. Marcotte shooting it in. O'Reilly on the right side. Robinson got it to center. Rick Smith back to Milbury. Ahead of course to O'Reilly. Shoot! Dryden blocked back. Now they fight for it along the boards. Miller trying to get it. Lafleur coming out over the line. Colombier over to Riseborough. Back to Lafleur. He fired it wide. It's at the side of the net. Here's Riseborough trying to center it. In on the boards they go, and they get a whistle. So we have Mondu at center. He'll face Rattel. Lafleur trying to bat it toward the corner. Intercepted by Rattel. He rolls it gently down the ice. You know, Icy Robinson with an effort could have easily have got that. Now Park slapped it back in there, and he hit his man. Here's Rattel. Over to Cashman. He fired it. And that one went off on Dewar Robinson over the glass in behind Dryden. 3 minutes and 17 seconds have been played in the overtime, and the trend in recent years, Lou, in overtime, fairly quick goals.
Well, you see right here, too, that Dryden didn't know where the puck was, and Cashman shot that puck where two goals have been scored on the short side. Yvonne Cornway, the captain of the Montreal Canadiens, out with an injury this year, right now looking on very worried. But Boston had some glorious opportunities this period, Danny.
Well, let's see what happens here. Face off to the right of Dryden. The Bruins, everybody up. Richel against Jarvis. In there, they try to get it. Big Robinson, Romp through, gets it up on the left side to Gainey. Here's Gainey. Park stopped him. Cashman is back. Cashman clearing it to Park. Score tied four in the first overtime period. Four apiece. Now it's to Richel. He's checked. Here's Ray Janot coming in. Ray Janot trying to get in front. He does. Park cleared it away. Robinson in behind the net to Uhl. Sims tying up Uhl, being assisted there by Brad Park. Will we get a whistle? Cashman and Uhl start some shoving. Gainey is in there, but there is no damage being inflicted, and I'm almost certain that penalties will not be assessed here unless something more serious breaks up. From the faceoff, on the board, Canadians trying to center it, it's into the crease, and Shutt was able to work that puck off the boards, flip it into the crease, and when you get it in there with players milling about, you never know what's going to happen.
Well, he was actually trying to work it out free to LaFleur, who's standing in front of the net. But instead, the puck was caromed off the defenseman's skate right here into Gilbert. Here comes LaFleur, and that's where he was trying to pass it.
Now LaFleur is poised for a shot if it comes back. Canadians trying to keep it in. Here's LaFleur in the back end. Oh, he fired it wide. What a glittering opportunity there for the Canadians, LaFleur, to wind up this series. Now the Bruins coming down. Marcotte shooting it into the corner. Early in this overtime, the Bruins had the good scoring opportunities. Then Montreal. Now Montreal starting out with Robinson, clearing it ahead to shut to LaFleur. LaFleur is over the line. Here's LaFleur centering it, and it's intercepted by Marcotte. Here's Robinson. Robinson getting set. He fired it to the short side. And Gilbert was there. There's the shot.
Well, that deflection by Jacques Lemaire caught Gilles Gilbert moving to his right. Gilles was able to get just a piece of it, enough of it to stop it in front of the crease. Here's a deflection. You saw Lemaire reach in, and there was the puck going towards the low corner on Gilles' glove side. Almost over the line, but not over, and Gilles does it again. Right now, big discussion going around with Bob Myers, Park, and Savard, and both of them defensemen. If Gilles looks nonchalant, that's Irvin Grundman, the general manager of the Montreal Canadiens. But the defensemen both in there talking, Danny, probably trying to get a ref. We've got Chartrand defense for the first time tonight.
Chartrand, Engblom playing up. O'Reilly gets it, hands it off to Park. He failed to clear it out. It's whipped back in there by Gainey. Lemaire coming from the side. Now into the center ice. Big McNabb takes the pass. He's in over the line. Marcotte is getting in front. It's flipped. Oh! Marcotte almost deflected that one in there. Here's LaFleur. Two on one. Bruins are getting back. LaFleur over the line. Oh! Not much of a shot, but what a save by Gilbert.
Well, end-to-end action and opportunities at both sides. LaFleur that time wanted to pass it to Gainey or Lemaire. He saw that he couldn't get it through, and he missed his shot. As LaFleur makes a nice little move right around Park, a little interference by Lemaire. He's going to break down the outside and look to pass it, but he can't. So now he's going to shoot it, and he didn't get all of it. Gilbert reaching out.
Pain can wear you down, but you're resilient. And I see how lidocaine patch fuels your resilience. Powerful, targeted pain relief. Pain will not get the best of you. It will bring out the best in you. Icy hot lidocaine patch.
If you're behind on your mortgage payments, threatened with foreclosure, denied a loan modification, or have been the victim of a predatory loan, the Stop Foreclosure Group can help. You have rights, and we have options. Call now for a free consultation.
If you are living with diabetes and using insulin, you know the pain of pricking your finger multiple times a day. US Med's mission is to find ways to make your diabetes more manageable and more comfortable. You deserve to enjoy life without the constant reminder of living with diabetes. You may qualify to receive a continuous glucose monitor with little or no cost to you. Call now for more information. A continuous glucose monitor provides blood sugar readings without uncomfortable finger sticks and alerts you real time to potentially harmful spikes in your blood sugar levels. US Med is an approved provider for Medicare and over 500 private insurance companies. If you're a caretaker for someone who suffers from diabetes or have diabetes yourself and meet these conditions, please call our diabetic specialist now to see if you qualify for your continuous glucose monitor.
Call 1-800-605-7967. That's 1-800-605-7967.
Like an Alex Ovechkin one time. Nothing can stop the NHL Tonight crew from talking hockey.
Seth, it was awesome to see you back on the rink.
I also feel like it's been a lifetime since I skated.
NHL Tonight. Tonight, 6 Eastern on NHL Network. Nightly highlights, live games, and insightful analysis. This is NHL Network.
Well, now the face-off to the right is still there. 48-29, the overall total in shots. And in this overtime, we have Montreal with 4-5, and Boston has exactly 2. But they had 2 good scoring chances, the Bruins. Réjean Houle against Miller. Into the corner it goes. Miller whipped it into the other side. Milbury gets it out over the line. It's down the ice. Robinson watching Cashman. Cashman has 2 goals for the Bruins tonight. His second goal gave the Bruins a 3-1 lead, which they took into the third period. Now here's Middleton. Middleton working the corner, takes the sharp angle shot. Lambert coming on. Réjean Houle over to Tremblay. Back to Houle. To Tremblay cutting in. He shoots. Oh, how did they stop that one with Lambert? Right at the corner. It looked like the net was wide open. Now Robinson, struggling to get out, gets it into the center ice area. Houle back to Robinson. Robinson working in there on the backhand, a weak backhander. Lambert over on the other side. Gilbert clearing it in there. Tremblay whipping it to the other side. Lambert getting set back to Lafleur. Ashman is after Lafleur. Sharp angle shot that time by Lafleur. And it came off the boards back down the ice. Here is Middleton after Savard to the other side. Lafleur picking it up in his own zone up to Robinson. Here is Schott being tied up by Schmatz. Schmatz poked it ahead. Robinson clearing it out. The Bruins stop it again. Here's Marcotte going in after Savard. Marcotte around the net. He centered it. Over on the other side. Brad Park. In it goes to Schmatz. Rattel on the boards. He's tied up by Schott. Robinson got it, but the whistle had gone. 13:06 left in the first overtime period. So the Bruins have the opportunity with the faceoff in the Canadian zone. Here's O'Reilly centering it. Coming out for Montreal. Napier. He has Gainey with him over the line. Broken up by Park. O'Reilly cleared it out. Now Gainey going in into the corner. There's Napier taking a look. He tries to center it. Jarvis moves in. Jarvis along the boards around the net. Jarvis trying to center it. Stopped by Park. Now picking his way is O'Reilly. O'Reilly dropping it back to Park, and the Bruins are starting out. Park lost it, recovers. Park clearing it ahead. Jonathan knocked it into the center ice area. Napier coming in on that left side. Taken out of the play very effectively by Sims. O'Reilly around the net. McNabb looks ahead, gets the pass to center. Ends up on Chartrand's stick. That's Engblom at the other side. The Bruins almost lost it. It was brought in fact, offside by Schott. What's amazing is the tempo that they continue to go at. Even Jacques Lemaire there, one of the elder statesmen of the Montreal Canadiens, constantly forechecking, putting on pressure. The Boston team being led by Rattel, a 39-year-old centerman this year, one of the finer skaters. Both of these clubs giving everything they have.
The longer they go, the happier are the New York Rangers.
That's right. But maybe one other team down there is going to be awful happy.
Now up on the left side, Marcotte. Got it to Miller. He scooped it in, chasing it to the other side. Rick Smith is back into the center ice area. Here is Schmatz going to the line. Slaps one into the corner. Miller, he's an excellent skater for the Bruins, going after Savard. LaFleur coming up. Up on the left side, shot getting set. He fired it. It wasn't too tough a shot, actually. He didn't get that great velocity that he generally gets when he winds up with a slap shot from the wing. Lemaire laying it in. LaFleur goes after Milbury. Ahead to Marcotte. Pass intercepted by Réjean. Ooh, Lambert winds up the shot nowhere near the net. It's cleared out and brought back in on the offside. Middleton, Rattel, and Cashman for the Bruins. Ooh, Lambert and Trombley for the Canadiens. And now Sims gets it ahead to Middleton. He cleared it in. Cashman and Rattel moving in to the other side. Trombley gets it to the line. At center, Réjean Ooh with Lambert. Ooh getting set. Still has it. Backhand shot. Not too much on the shot, but that spinorama shot is always difficult. There's only one thing a goalie wants to do with somebody rushing in. It's just smother.
Especially in an instance like that when you have Brad Park in front with Lambert. Park doing a fine job tying up Lambert, and you don't want any rebound there because Lambert could reach over and get that puck.
9 minutes and 5 seconds have already elapsed in the first overtime period.
How about that Wayne Cashman? With all this ice time tonight again.
Just a tremendous player, and he shows what stamina really is. He came out of a hospital bed, as a matter of fact, after the second game. Now Brad Park ahead to Cashman. Lambert going back in, jammed out of the play by Park. Here's Middleton turning on that right side. Middleton trying to get through there. And Savard, the veteran, stopped him. Here's Trombley hitting the Boston line. Trombley cutting. Center to right. They score! Lambert! He found Lambert from the doorstep of Phil Gilbert. Sends him up y'all for him into a frenzy. After he takes that pass from Mario Trombley at the doorstep, makes no mistake, and puts the Montreal Canadiens into the Stanley Cup Finals against the New York Rangers.
11 days later, the Canadiens would win their fourth straight cup by defeating another original six rival, the New York Rangers. As for the Bruins, this would turn out to be Don Cherry's last game behind the Boston bench. He was fired in the offseason and would end up coaching in Colorado. Thanks for watching Vintage Games here on the NHL Network. We'll see you again next time.